Hello children, this is third standard social science textbook. All of you open your textbook, page number 241. Page number 241. In the previous period already you have studied Northern Plains, then mountains and hills. Land forms are also called physical features. Okay, then Aravalli Range crosses four states: Rajasthan, Delhi, Haryana, and Gujarat. Okay, then Nilgiri Hills are also called Blue Mountains. Annamalai Hills are also called Elephant Hills. Okay, already you have studied those points. Today we are going to study about the next part of the that page number 241, desert. Next part, that is desert. Desert means dry region, no rain or dry region, that is desert. One day Sumita came to class dressed in a traditional Rajasthani dress. It was her birthday, because on that day her birthday, so she came to class dressed in a traditional. In Rajasthani dress, that is a traditional dress. Why? Because on that day was her birthday. She had visited Rajasthan recently. So she wore a dress, Rajasthani traditional dress. Fortunately, they were going to study about the only desert in India, the Thar Desert. On that day, only she is going to study about the desert in India. Which desert is that? That is Thar Desert. Okay? See here, children, they have given here India map. In that left side is Pakistan. Near the desert is there. That is Rajasthan. Thar Desert, it is in Rajasthan. See here, in the India, the Thar Desert is there, the near the Rajasthan. Okay, that is in the Rajasthan. The Thar Desert, also known as the Great Indian Desert. Why we call it one? Because it is very large, great. So we call it Great Indian Desert. Which one we call it? The Thar Desert is called Great Indian Desert. It is the one more name. It is in the northwest part of India. Northwest, see here, in this side, east, west, north, south. The downside is south. In the between north and west, it will comes northwest. Already you know the directions, already you have studied. Four directions, sub directions, main directions. Four main directions, four sub directions, already you have studied. See here, north and the west, between it comes northwest. Okay, north and east between it comes northeast. Then south and east between comes southeast. South and west between comes southwest. That like we have to studied. Here they have given in the northwest part of India, the Thar Desert is there. Okay, see here, it forms a natural boundary between India and Pakistan. India, this is the India. See here, boundary, this one is here, Pakistan India boundary between. See here, okay, about 85% of it is in India. How much part there in India? That is about 85%. More than Pakistan, it is 85% in India, the Thar Desert. It is very dry desert, okay, and also great Indian desert. Only a little part extends into the states of Gujarat, Punjab and Haryana. In the beside they have given here Punjab, you can see here, which I am marking, that one you see, Punjab this is. Below they have given Haryana. Then in this side Gujarat, the third desert left is Gujarat and the right side is Punjab and Haryana. Okay, this like the states of Gujarat, Punjab and Haryana. Only a little parts extends. Okay, Sumita, now please tell the class about your experience in Rajasthan. Because already she had visited Rajasthan recently, so her teacher asked to this question. We visited the cities of Jaipur and Jaisalmer. Jaipur and Jaisalmer. And we spent 2 days in a tent in the Thar desert. Where she had spent 2 days? She has spent 2 days in a tent in the Thar desert only. See here, the Sumita visited the cities of Jaipur and Jaisalmer and she spent 2 days in a tent in the Thar desert. It is full of sand because it is a Thar desert. So there is very sand. It is full of sand and very hot during the day. If there is no trees or forests, on that place is very hot in the daytime only. Okay, I almost thought we could cook an egg without a fire. See here children, how it was the hot there. How it was the hot. I almost thought we could cook an egg without a fire. We don't want to fire to cook the egg. Why? Because there is a lot of fire. It means the sun rays is very hot. The sun rays are very hot. We get a lot of heat. So the eggs will cook without fire. So she is telling this like, there were hardly any trees. We travelled up and down the sand dunes on camels. Sand dunes. See here. This is the word, you can remember this one. Sand dunes on camels. I used to feel ticklish as the camels climbed down the dunes. It was fun. Why? Because the camels used to feel ticklish to climb down the dunes. So it was fun. We were all carrying our own water. I wonder how camels store water in their bodies. So we call those camels ship of desert. The camels lives in the desert. So we call those ship of desert. What is that animal? Camel. Okay? Because it is wonder why, how the camels store water in their bodies. Then without water it lives for a long time. Without a water the camel lives a long time. Okay, nights were very cold, days are very hot, nights are very cold. Both the nights our hosts lit small fires and we all sang and danced with them under the starry skies. Okay, These are some photographs. See here. These are some photographs she shared with her classmates and teachers. Okay? Turn the page. See here, children. Central and South India. Central and South India. To the south of the Thar Desert. See here, to the south of the Thar Desert and the Indo-Gangetic Plains lies the Deccan Plateau. Already you know what is the mean by plateau. Okay? In the previous lesson, already you have studied that one. Desert, okay? See here, in the south of the Thar Desert and the Indo-Gangetic Plains lies the Deccan Plateau. Okay, observe and tell this one. Look at the map on page number 4141. Okay, look at the map on page number 41. Write down the names of hill, ranges and hills. Ranges and hills. Okay? See here, they have given here some okay children, look at the map on page number 41. Write down the names of the hill ranges and hills. They have given here some places. We will fill. Okay? Now we want to fill. I will tell you one by one. You write down that. Okay? First one is Aravalli. A-R-A-V-A-L-L-I. They have given R. Write you A-N-G-E. The second one is V-I-N-D-H-Y-A R-A-N-G-E. Vindhya Range. Third one is R A J M A H A L, then H I L L S, Raj Mahal Hills. The fourth one is Satpur, S A T P U R A, R A N G E, Satpur Range. The fifth one is E A S T E R N, G H A T S, Eastern Ghats. W-E-S-T-E-R-N-G-H-A-T-S, Western Ghats. Seventh one, N-I-L-G-I-R-E, Nilgiri, H-I-L-L-S, Nilgiri Hills. The eighth one is A-N-A-I-M-A-L-A-I, H-I-L-L-S, Anaimala Hills. These form a kind of triangle. Inside this triangle of hills lies the Deccan Plateau. These are all, it means triangle. This is form a kind of triangle. Inside this triangle of hills lies Deccan Plateau. Okay. The land here is higher than the surrounding plains. The land here is higher than the surrounding plains. So it is a plateau. The land is also hard and rocky. The land is also hard and rocky and not as fertile as the plains. There is no fertile because so many parts on that, from that parts will bring fertile soil. If there is no fertile, that plains, no fertile soil, many rivers flow through the Deccan Plateau. Many rivers, so many rivers flows on the plateaus. They will bring fertile soil. Those becomes plains, very fertile, okay, to grow the crops. The plateau slopes from west to east, and that is why most rivers in this region flow from west to east. East, west, north, south. Here east, here west, this is the south. In this side east, in this side west, here north, here south. Indian Ocean in the south side. Okay? west to east, west to east. This rivers region flow from this side to this side. The Mahanadi, the Mahanadi Godavari. See here, which I have underlined. Which I have underlined, you have to see properly that those are the rivers. Godavari, then Krishna, see here, Krishna, Kaveri flows into the Bay of Bengal. See here, this is the Bay of Bengal. Only the Narmada, Tapi, Narmada and Tapi, Narmada and Tapi are flows into Arabian Sea. See here, this is the Arabian side. Arabian Sea in this side, west side is there, this the Indian Sea is south side, the Bay of Bengal is east side, okay? These rivers flow from which side to which side? From west to east. These are flows into Bay of Bengal. The Tapi and Narmada. Tapi and Narmada flows into the Arabian Sea. These rivers are not snow-fed. They depend upon the monsoon for water. Okay? These are depend upon monsoon for water. There is no fed. Okay? Many of them dry up during the summer. So many rivers in the summer time, they have dried. There is no water. Little bit of water only there. They are not fully water. The next page. Okay. The peninsula. The peninsula has the Bay of Bengal on the east. Peninsula is the Bay of Bengal. Okay. Bay of Bengal in the east side. The Arabian Sea on the west. The Arabian Sea on the west side and the left sea. Arabian Sea, it is this side only. Bay of Bengal in this side. Indian Sea, it is in this side. Okay? The Indian Sea, ocean in the south. Yes. The southernmost tip of Indian mainland is Kanyakumari. Where? Southernmost tip. See here, in this map, they have showed here one more. Different is there here. You can see this one. Given here. Okay. This part we call it Kanyakumari. Okay. We call it Kanyakumari. Southern most tip of the Indian mainland is Kanyakumari. Okay. Between the gates and ghats and the water bodies lie the coasts. Along the coasts, there are narrow strips of low flat land. No, low flat land. So we call those coastal plains. These are beautiful. These are very beautiful to see. The coastal plains on the east are broader than the coastal plains on the west. The coastal plains on the east are broader to the than the coastal plains on the west. Okay, find out this one. They have asked here two questions. You have to tell me the answer. Names of any three crops that farmer grow in the eastern coast. In the eastern coast, what type of crops the farmers grow? I will tell you this answer. You have to remember this one. Wheat, cotton, corn, soybean. Remember it. Wheat, cotton, corn, soybean. The second one is names of any three crops. Names of any three crops that farmers grow in the western coast. Grow in the western coast. I will tell you this one answer also. Rice, jowar, wheat, maize, pulses. Okay. These crops that farmers grow in the western coast. Okay, Preetish could not wait to get home from school. He wanted to study the physical map of India he had in his collection. He located and ticked the everything he had learnt in school that day, what he has studied on that day. He wanted to tick that located in everything, okay, in that map. Okay, see here children, they have given here one physical map. This is so many collections he had, so many collections he located and ticked everything what he had learnt in that day. Okay, Himalaya mountains, Indo-Gangetic plains, Thar desert, hill ranges, the Ghats, the coastal plains, Kanyakumari, the snow-fed rivers, the Deccan Plateau, the rivers of the Deccan Plateau, the peninsula. These are the collections already he has studied in these parts. Okay, you already studied. Okay, turn the page. See here children, in this page we will study. There are two sets of islands, the Andaman and Nicobar. These are the two sets of islands. What are the names of two sets of islands? Andaman and Nicobar are two sets of islands are in the Bay of Bengal. Already you know this one. Islands, Andaman and Nicobar, where they are located? Bay of Bengal. A canal separates Andaman from Nicobar. Both the islands have rainforests with thousands of different plants, hundreds of birds, butterflies and moths. Okay, see here in this side picture tells us crocodiles, deer and wild bear live here, and there is a lots of fish too. In the Arabian Sea we have a group of islands called Lakshadweep Islands. See here, only between the land is there, surrounding that is the water, we call it Lakshadweep. Lakshadweep means surrounding the water, in between only the land is called Lakshadweep. Okay, see here children, they have given about these lesson, tells us, gives us so many points. I will read for you this one, you can remember this one. Okay, I will read for you these points. Okay, please you will remember this one. After one you have to read this. India has a variety of landforms. Yes, so many varieties of landform are there in the India. The land surface keeps changing from place to place. It is also correct, because the land surfaces place to place, it will change. The Himalayan mountain range is in the north of India. To the south of the Himalayas lies in the northern plains, also called the Indo-Gangetic plains. These are very fertile. The Indo-Gangetic plains are watered by the snow-fed rivers from the Himalayas. Yes, the Thar desert lies in the northwest part of India. To the south of the Thar desert lies the Deccan Plateau. There are many hills, ranges in the Deccan Plateau. The rivers of the Deccan Plateau depend upon the monsoons for water. The peninsula has the Bay of Bengal on the east, the Arabian Sea on the west, and the Indian Ocean in the south. Whenever you want to see the map on that time, you can observe this one. Because in every map, already you have seen, in every map these are in the Bay of Bengal on the east side, the Arabian Sea in the west side, and Indian Ocean in the south side. In every map and every time you want to see this one. Okay, the next one, between the Ghats and the water bodies lies the coasts. The Andaman and Nicobar islands are in the Bay of Bengal. These are the two islands. sets of two islands. These are the Andaman and Nicobar. The Lakshadweep islands are in the Arabian Sea. Okay, it is in Arabian Sea. Here, so many animals. Crocodiles are there, deers, wild bears. Okay, and then lots of fishes will be there. Here, in that side the islands. So many rainforests are there with thousands of different plants, hundreds of birds, butterflies and moths. Okay, next. Okay, children, I will tell you this one. India has a variety of landform. This is yes or no? Yes. Right here, yes. Desert or wetlands? No. Dry lands, they are all dry lands, so it is no. The river Kaveri flows in the northern plain? No. The river Kaveri flows in Bay of Bengal, northern place, it is no. Okay. The Thar desert in the state of Rajasthan? Yes, it is in Rajasthan. The plain surface on high land is called plateau? Yes. A peninsula is surrounded by water on two sides? No. A peninsula is surrounded by water on two sides, it is no. Okay. See here, children, so many questions and given word they have given here. Page number 245 and 46 is there. Here, page number 246. Here they have given. Okay. So I will show you this one. Cactus. Which land forms do the following belongs to? Use the color code to color. Use the color code to color. I will fill this one color. Afterwards, I will send you. You have to copy this one neatly in your given social workbook. And then your social study textbook also. I will send you this. All question answers, then give one word answers, and then national anthem, our national anthem. How well do you know our national anthem? These questions will be, answers will be, I will send you afterwards. These also, I will fill the color afterwards. I will send you these. Copy this in your given textbook and your social study workbook. Okay, children, once again, you have to read this lesson. Then, which we have sent the videos, you have to see that videos 2 to 3 times. On that time, you have to understand that lesson. Then, when you want to watch the video, on that time, you sit with your textbook. Okay, children? Take care. Bye.